Hello everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy XV. In the last episode, we went down there, into the mines. It was fun. We kicked the shit out of a Marlboro. It kind of pissed me off a little bit because I couldn't figure out how to do it, but it's cool. We had fun. We had fun. Ignis is good, right? You good, Iggy? Oh, that's Gladio. Good, Iggy, wherever you're at, you're good, right? Anyways, we're about to get back on the train and we're going to stop by Tenebrae, which is right over there, according to the map anyways. Sorry if I don't sound all enthusiastic today, guys. It's just one of them days. Life happens, you get over it, you move on. But today, the show must go on, regardless of how Funky feels, he must record. Because, well, it's one of the only ways to get my mind off of things. So anyways, let's not talk about life, let's talk about what's going on in this life. Let's reboard that train, shall we? On the way to Tenebrae. Hey, hey, hey.
All set for boarding?
You know I am, sir. You cannot return. Oh no! Wait, actually,
not yet.
Is there any reason to not leave here yet?
Just let me know when your preparations are in order.
He did say there's no way to return. Now I'm assuming I can still backtrack to, back to the Lucis and freaking Altissia still. But I'm assuming I won't be able to actually come back to this place. I'm just gonna make sure anything at the shops, which nothing was unique at these shops anyways. Or at least not that shop. What about this one? I don't remember now.
Greetings.
I'm going to double check and make sure I bought everything. All right, you don't sell anything unique either. All right, cool. That's probably by design. Just in case you didn't buy everything. Now, I'm pretty sure... I shouldn't say I'm pretty sure about anything. I'm hoping that I found all the blue items around here. I'm hoping that's the case. I'm just taking one more look over here because I never really... I just didn't say never, but I don't remember making sure I checked every little nook and cranny back here. I do remember seeing the bed, but I don't remember. Did I run all the way back here? I probably did. The fact that there's no shiny all the way back here probably means I did. Alright, well, I'm just going to go ahead and let it go. I mean, I have this save spot if I really think I missed something, but I was pretty thorough. This place isn't that, like, confusing. It's just really long. You gotta run all the way along the damn... freaking rail yard to get to the other ends and shit. I'm not doing that again right now. We already did that before.
All set.
So let's
boarding.
Just fucking board and go to Tenebrae, huh? I mean, what could I possibly miss here that's going to be that,
in that case,
like, important?
We'll be leaving
Would
shortly.
They leave something here that's super important? I mean, I'm sure I picked up some items that were useful.
We're here for you.
Yeah. Let us help you.
And we're off.
Are we
and
clear?
We're off. Dude, if Ignis is
really
cool
You're
enough,
pushing onward,
not at his expense,
he'll just be like Daredevil.
Fair enough.
Oh no, no, no! Get your fucking bitch ass out of here! You are not on the same train as me. Don't you even dare set foot in Tenebrae. Is that the end of the chapter? I guess it is, because that's the name of the chapter right there, the Heart of the King. Heart of the King, the Heart of the Cards. The Heart of the King, the Heart of the Cards. Finally finished Chapter 10, guys. We've been on Chapter 10 for so long because we did side quests for like 5 or 6 episodes. Chapter 10 is finally completo. Yay. All right. A little bit of experience for everything. Whoa. That looks pretty fancy, actually, with all the fucking mist going on, black and white. I don't know what the hell that is. Or that. Just a lot of people staring in dark corners. There's a part of the Marlboro. Well, there's the whole Marlboro. Now we're talking. That's a good pick. Oh, shit. Look at that one. That's a fucking action shot if I ever saw one. We were fighting the Marlboro for an extra long time, so you have to take that into account. I don't know if I really like this one. It's mysterious, but I don't know if I like it. I'm just going to leave it at that. The two Marlboro shots are fine. Nothing too amazing in those shots. Nothing. Most of it's dark and dreary because we were in a damn mine. But anyway, guys, it's time to end for Chapter 11, In the Dark. Ignis's resolve forces a reconciliation between Noctis and Gladiolus and restores harmony to the group. With renewed vigor, the four friends reboard the train and head for Tenebrae, home of the late Lady Luna Freya. R.I.P. Luna Freya. Poor Luna, man. Didn't even get to seal the deal before she died. Not cool. Not cool. The only thing that's, like, okay with me having her die, and I shouldn't say I'm okay with it because I'm, you know, it's not a good thing. But the thing that's okay about it is that I saw the movie, you know, the Kingsglaive movie, and there was plenty of her in that movie. She's like the co-star of the movie. Luna and this other character who's the star of the movie. Like, that's pretty much, we'll just call him Jesse Pinkman. Jesse Pinkman and Luna Freya are the main characters in the movie. At least two of them.
Feels good to ride the rails.
Anyway, sure back is. On train.
To drive once we're in Gralia.
If they'll let me.
We're fortunate Gralia? To have the regalia at all. We owe the First Secretary our thanks.
She'd get more thanks if she gave us a discount.
Those transceivers are top-notch. I recall when the Hydrian raged. In the midst of the Empire's retreat, one conspicuous craft remained behind. The Chancellor's. The last thing I remember seeing was his ship heading for the altar.
Ignis actually saw it.
I fell unconscious and was powerless to stop him.
I'm just glad you're alive.
Oh. Is someone else there?
Gladio. He just came back. Where did he go anyway?
On a brief reconnaissance. Something caught my ear.
Hey, Captain. Mission complete.
Splendid.
So what caught your ear?
Rumors of longer nights.
They've been growing longer day by day.
There was talk of it back in Lucis, but recent days have shown an unseasonably sharp change.
Huh.
Should this trend continue, before long...
There won't be daylight.
Well, it's not out of the question. The Empire has already slain half of the Six. No wonder the whole world's in disarray.
I guess.
And longer nights mean more demons.
Seen that with our own eyes.
I happened to overhear a fellow passenger discussing this very same phenomenon.
So he sent yours truly to seek him out.
Nice police work.
Well, don't want to keep him waiting.
No, we don't. Back in a moment.
Sure.
So when they say slain half the Six, they mean the three that I have that I can summon? Those three are technically dead? Is that what that means? Or does that mean the other three? Shiva, Ifrit, and who's the third one? Bahamut, maybe? Does that mean they're already dead? Or is it the other way around, like I said?
Whoa! Oh, there you are, buddy. Did you see this? Oh, it's unreal.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know what we're seeing, but I guess we're gonna get a cutscene of it.
Never seen
maybe?
Anything like it.
Was it like desolate wasteland or?
Doesn't make any sense.
Super high tech or what are we talking about? What doesn't make any sense? I don't get it. Is it snowy? Is he having one of his visions again? Nox having vision quest again? Wait, what?
What's going on?
Wait, what the hell? Everyone's frozen
it's
in time?
A real mystery.
Oh, shit.
I'm not liking that snow cloud. Kind of gives me the chills. Like, who comes up with this stuff? I couldn't dream something like this if I tried. It's a wondrous world.
This music makes me think we're gonna attack him. Can we attack him? Fucking asshole.
What are you doing here?
What's going on?
Easy there, buddy. Oh, didn't see that coming. You all right?
You know what? You fuck you.
Shut up! Be careful there! Wait, is this for real?
What are we talking about? I'm confused as to why he's so confused. What is happening right now? Frozen time? Did he not expect there to be frozen time, or is he fucking with us? You son of a bitch.
Show yourself! Knocked.
That son of a bitch.
Why is he fucking... Huh? I'm so very confused right now. Where'd he go? Where'd this son of a bitch go? Where'd he go?
Come on, Knocked. You're scaring me. Seriously, man. Cut it out.
Now he's just fucking with us. I don't like that he's fucking with us. It's not cool. I find this
it's
to be very
safe.
Unprofessional,
Plus,
you're
sir. You're causing a scene. Quit playing around.
You think this is funny?
Dude, are you seriously trying to kill me?
Dude.
Why wouldn't I? I've got... What are you after following me around this whole time? It's all your fault!
What are you talking about? Do you really mean that, Noct?
Yeah. 100%.
Of course I do! You can't talk your way out of this.
You won't even let me. Noct, please, can't we talk for a sec?
Never.
The hell? Did the train hit something, or what just happened? I'm so confused right now. Why was everything frozen? Was Arden actually freezing everything, or was that something else? So confused. Ushiello, the deserts of the western continent have long been littered with the Imperial armories and outposts. The slaying of the Glacian, however, gave birth to the paradoxical phenomenon, snowfields and sand dunes coexisting miles apart, mere miles apart. Okay, so the Glacian is probably Shiva, and what, that means Shiva's already dead. And thus, the snow or whatever that Noct and Prompto were looking at out the window, there was snow and there was sand really close to each other? Is that what the wonder was? Is that what the confusion was? I'm assuming that, based on this description right here, that's probably what that means. Huh. We'd be wise to flee this treacherous terrain post-haste. But first I want the power of the Glacian. That'd be pretty sweet, if we can. I want to be able to summon Shiva. You can't only have male summons. Oh, okay. Leviathan's technically a female. Let's be serious. But no, nobody wants not to okay? stare at a non-humanoid summon. It's just a snake-looking thing.
He's here? If he is, that would explain all this weird stuff happening. I bet he's behind the train stopping. Ignis and Gladio went up to inspect the engine room. I say the two of us go check out the rear.
Yeah.
You know what? Now that we're talking about the Glacian, real quick, is it possible that her power is around here? I mean, the train froze. She does have the power of ice. Does it make sense to think that Shiva possibly froze the train? That'd be pretty cool. You know, once I start thinking about her. Oh my god, what?
Did they bomb us? Not. We have to protect the people.
Who's bombing who? Wait, what's happening right now? I mean, the windows just got, like, oh, jeez, what? Oh, apparently there's an armored axeman coming in. Why are they attacking us? I don't know. Get the fuck out of here, armored axeman. You have no chance against my level 52 ass, okay? Get out of here.
Let's check the rear.
Let's keep going.
Need to get the train moving again.
Get the train moving again, suckas. Everybody run.
Let's go.
I got you. Everybody run.
How bad do you think it is?
Certainly hope it's just fine, but one can only hope. Oh boy. Yeah, what is... I mean, I guess we know what's busting these things open. There's fucking soldiers afoot. Are we really only gonna fight one soldier on the way over here? Really? Just one? Just one. You're telling me we're just gonna fight just one? Oh, Jesus! Okay, we probably need to get rid of some of these guys. What do you say? Let's go get them. Get them, Noct. You don't fuck with the train. Imperial shock troopers are determined to load the train. Take them down before they get too close. The train. Got it. Game over. Impending. Don't let it happen. Got it. Take out all the Imperials. Show them who the fuck is boss. All right, got rid of him. Me and Prompto's got this. Got rid of some of these fuckers. Get the fuck out of here, Armored Axe Man. I know I'm not actually saving the train at the moment. That's alright, I got rid of all the Axe Men. Wait, we want to get rid of these fucking guns. Wait, how do I get rid of the guns? The guns are what's fucking shit up. Wait, that was it?
He's back on his feet.
Wait, who's back on whose feet? What? It's like I see red dots. I'm trying to find dudes. Fuck off, dudes. Get out of here. What? Why do I keep seeing red dots when I don't see the guys? It's because they're coming from off the damn screen. Get out of here, you armored fucks. I don't understand what I'm supposed to do here. Like, I understand him kicking their ass. Who's he? Is it because I... Do I have to take... I mean, I get that these big-ass gun tank thingies are what's, like, attacking the shit out of my train. I'm fucking these guys up. I'm not having any problem killing all these guys. This is not a problem. Just keep stabbing these fools to death. Like, this is not a problem. We can rock this all night long. And I think that's kind of the point. I don't know. Whatever, just keep fucking them up. This fucking guy. Shock trooper? No, that's a bad shock trooper. Okay, so I must be doing a good job. Ow, I didn't know he was gonna explode. Get ready here, you shock trooping asshole. Quit telling me he's ready for round two when I don't even know who you're talking to, bro. Get out of here, you shocking asshole. My fucking warp strike from hella far away is kind of rocking some tits right now. The Imperial tank has also begun firing. He was already firing. Point warp to the tank. Destroy it before it shoots. Got it. Point warp. You get out of there, you piece of shit. Damn, he just tore that shit off with his bare fucking hands. Don't even know how knock rolls right now. Get some. Nice. We're leaving. Oh, okay. I'm assuming we gotta warp train our ass back. Okay. Game did it for me. I didn't have to really do anything. Are we expecting more fighting going on up here? Look, I believe we are.
They're hot on our tail.
I see.
They're gonna blow us to
more dudes. Motherfucker, get out of here. Get off my train. This ain't your train. My train, ho. Imperial assault crafts have begun firing on the train. Point warp to ships and destroy them. Oh, great. Man, this is an epic sequence. I'm not gonna lie. It's pretty epic. How do I... I don't know what I'm supposed to do. How do I bring them down? Confused on what I'm supposed to do. Oh, okay. I actually have to go inside of them. Makes sense. Once inside, force the shock troopers to self-destruct. We'll use one of the turrets to take down the four assault crafts. Okay. Well, I guess I got rid of this one. We should probably get the fuck out of here. I see. Self-destruct these bitches and then get the fuck out. I got it. I see. Okay, I understand at least. Get the fuck out of here, huh? Alright. Easy enough. I got this. Sucks to be y'all. Y'all are exploding, right? No? Can I not explode enough of you? Ah. There you go. That worked. Alright, let's get up in there. Wait, this one doesn't have an opening. Okay. That one does, though. That one's open. Alright. Got it. Got it. Ow, ow, ow. Don't blow up on me. Turn to the train. 8 seconds. Got it. Oh, shit. What?
How long were you in the dark?
What the fuck just happened? That was the whole chapter? And Prompto fell off the train? Oh my god, I'm so... That was overwhelming. And that was the end of the chapter. What? Chapter 11 is over like that? Don't blink, guys. You might miss it. The hell? You just have a story chapter that takes 10 minutes. Okay, that's fine. Chapter 12, End of Days. Arden uses a stitch in time to switch appearances with Prompto. Oh, that wasn't even... Oh. and tricks Nacht into hurting his closest friend. Oh, that's what just happened? That was confusing. I didn't even realize that's what happened. So basically Nacht threw Prompto from the train. Wow, that's more fucked up than I thought. Anyway, he pushes ever onward, accepting the consequences and never looking back. Yeah, okay. It looks like we're still going to Tenebrae based on this picture, though. End of days? What does that even mean, man? That can't be the end, right? Like, there's more, right? I mean, I'm 100... Wait, what? Game over. The game ends when not... Oh, duh. Okay. I was going to say, I'm 100% sure this game's at least 13 chapters, but I thought it was more than that. I don't know. I find it hard to believe we're this close to the end of the story, though. Jesus. So he knocked our ass out and he just left us on top of the train and nothing happened? So now what? So where's our friends at? Like, did we literally knock Prompto off the train? Is he okay? Like, I'm confused.
Ignis, you've got to stop this thing. Prompto fell off the train. I pushed him. I mean, Arden made me. I don't know where he is, but we can't leave him.
Stay calm, Nacht. I'm as concerned for Prompto as you are. But stopping the train would endanger everyone on board. We'd be sitting ducks for the demons.
What do we do?
First, we drop the passengers off at Tenebrae. We'll be arriving shortly.
What about Prompto?
Given the Chancellor's involvement, it's probable he's no longer where we left him. In any case, he may try to contact us. Let us wait and hope for now. Can you make your way here? Gladio's with me.
Are the two of you okay at least?
Yes.
Okay, on my way. I'll be there as soon as I take care of these stowaways.
Oh, we got stowaways? What the hell? Yeah, that's about as stowaway as you get. You know what? Fuck your snag of batches. This gargoyle looks crazy. This gargoyle's about to get fucked up, though. Sucks to be a gargoyle level 32 when I'm so good, sucka. Get some, you snagga. Come here, you snagga. Don't you dare move away from me. Get out of here. More? Oh, you got more. Wait, where's more? I don't see more. Oh, there you are. Hello, more. Get out of here, you shits. You got some more? You got some more where that came from? I just keep running up the train. I guess I'm gonna keep running up the train and hope that there's more. I should hope there's more, but I expect there to be more. Yeah, the music makes me think there's definitely gonna be more. Get some gargoyle. Boom, motherfucker! That was awesome. Fucking wrecked him in like one thing. Dude, look at this. They're all over the walls in here. Are you seeing this? Where are they coming from? They fucking live here, dude. This is their home. We're infiltrating their home right now. This is the troll tunnel. I can take as much more of this as fucking possible, bro. Don't try to act like you can't handle more of this. I just realized that the objective told me to make my way toward the front of the car. We're trying. We're working our way there. Oh, here they are. I see them on the map. Show them in my face so I can kill them. Damn snaggas. Fuck some snaggas up. Snaggas don't really want none. If I could fight some snaggas by the name of I don't even know another word, so let's just keep moving on. Who wants some now? Goblinos. Snaggalicious, baby. Also, that sounds like a really, really loud growl, howl that we just heard. What the fuck was that shit?
At the end of the tunnel.
Am I here? I must be here. Oh, look, more gargoyles. Hold out until the train clears the tunnel. All right. I'm doing just fine, you know? Everything's cool. Whoa, bigger things. What the fuck? Oh my god. I think the train might... Oh my god, there's a whole fucking crew of them. There's four. What? Oh shit. Did I summon Leviathan? I didn't do that, did I? I definitely didn't do that. Leviathan, I didn't call for your help, did I? Not that this isn't epic and everything, But I don't remember calling for your help, sir. I mean, ma'am. Then again, if you can help clean off the train, I'd be much obliged. Just don't knock the train off its fucking thing. Wow. Okay. I guess that's how you summon Leviathan accidentally. Meaning not on purpose at all. It just kind of happened. We did it. Woot. Alright. Toughest quest ever. Alright, everybody looks fine. No worse for the wear, right? Everything's cool, guys.
Well,
everything's
look
cool.
Who's here.
Oh, shit.
Haranea.
Hey, hey, hey.
Guess we've got you to thank for this mess.
More to it than meets the eye. You want to know who to thank? Come with me.
Wait, what? Come with you?
Can't wait to hear this.
We're not even going to say the name Prompto right now, I guess. Okay, let's just follow her for now, I guess.
What
did
you do to your eyes?
We have much choice
at
the moment.
No, just a flesh wound.
Just a flesh
wound. Can you see?
I'm afraid not.
Wow, that sucks.
Wait, Ignis can't see at all? I thought he could, like, kind of see. He was just fucked up. But he can't see at all? That's way worse. Alright, RNA.
Wasn't there one more of you guys?
Don't worry about it.
Yeah, there was.
We lost track of him.
Is he dead?
I don't know.
Then quit moping, keep hoping. And in the meantime, handle what's at hand.
You heard the girl. You heard her. That's kind of how I feel right now in my real life. When I was saying at the beginning of the episode, I was kind of sad. You know,
so if it's not
I could sit around and mope,
think.
Or I could just get over it.
Thank the demons. Pawns of the Imperial Army.
The army that you fight for.
Fought for. My men and I are in the search and rescue business now.
Wait, what? Who are you rescuing? Who are you trying to rescue?
You mentioned being part of the relief effort. We have a favor to ask.
Ask away.
In light of what you've told us, we can't allow the other passengers to continue on.
Sure, leave them to me. But who's gonna drive the train?
Now that you mention it, yeah. You know anyone?
I do. In fact, I know two.
You don't happen to mean these two guys standing right over here,
do you? Engineers. Biggs and Wedge.
Oh, shit. Biggs and Wedge.
Only if we have to. What's all this about?
Oh, I love their accent already.
Driving a train to Gralia.
That all?
Well, who would you have me ask?
You got us there.
Well, do we? Hey, really appreciate you going out of your way.
Yeah. No sweat.
Okay. So, Biggs and Wedge, huh? She did mention that Biggs and Wedge were, like, her team before, but we had never actually, like, I didn't even establish that that was them. But now we are seeing them again, which I'm glad, because I was a little worried that, like, the last time we saw her was the last time we would see her ever, and it would just kind of get left undone. But no, I'm glad we get to see her one more time. Not to say we won't see her more after this, but I'm just pointing out that we're not done seeing her yet. She's around still, and still looking mighty fine as ever, I must say. Aranea, man, when this is all over, maybe you can call this number. Oh, sorry, I was acting out a little something. Sorry, let's get back to the matters at hand. Let's speak to Biggs. Biggs has got, he's the one with the regular hat on, the Nazi hat.
Hey, thanks for the lift.
We're happy to help. Can't say the climate will be as cooperative, though, you know?
Right, especially the gorge.
The place is freezing. Makes sense what with the ice goddess's cold corpse lying around. It's a rather long ride, so I suggest you bundle up before we ship out. By the way, I bumped into a woman from the manor. Used to serve House Florey. Must have gone off looking for you. Said she had something important to discuss.
With me? Guess I ought to find her then.
Okay. There's a woman looking for me. I'm always down to find a woman. Also, dog. Wedge, what up?
So, you've cut your ties with the Empire?
Yeah.
The only way we could help the people was by leaving the army. Lady A'd about had it with them, as it were.
Lady A?
Aranea, the Commodore.
Ah.
Nothing but demons in the capital. Meanwhile, the crystal's just sitting there. No one in the army signed up for this.
What about the civilians?
Holed up in their homes.
They're either lying quiet behind closed doors or lying dead. Your guess is as good as mine.
Huh, so even the Empire's alienated their own people. Not a surprise there when
you'll be waiting on board. Give us a holler when you're ready to shovel.
Not a surprise when you fucking invite demons to be your army and then your human soldiers don't want to do it. Anyway, I guess now we're going to go this way? Yeah, okay. We got to find the person that the woman from that served some house or something. I don't know. See if we can find this woman in a timely manner. I really don't like that we're here at nighttime. It's kind of boring, all right? This place would probably look cool during the day, but I don't think there's much I can do about that now. Unless there's a campsite around here, but I don't seem to see one. I definitely see a fire thingy, though. Aw, yeah. Why are you absorbing so slow? Because apparently there was only a few damn things there. Never mind. Sky gemstone. Sounds kind of fancy. Alright. This must be the woman we're looking for. These are the women you're looking for. She doesn't look quite as cool as I thought she was going to look. In fact, she's downright annoying looking.
Is that you, Prince Noctis?
Yeah. Have we?
Oh, blessed be the stars. Just look at what a fine young man you've grown into.
Was she in the cutscene with Luna, like, way back in the beginning?
A retainer in service to House Floray. I doubt you'll remember me after.
Maybe she was. I think so.
I do.
Don't worry. Who I am is of little import in light of what I wish to discuss. Lady Luna Freya risked everything to spirit the Ring of the Lucii away from the Citadel. Did she deliver it to you?
Yeah.
Stars above! My fears have been assuaged. Lord Ravis II will be overjoyed to hear this news.
Ravis II?
Uh-oh. Who's Ravis I? No, I'm just kidding.
Inspire the king is your calling. You mustn't fall.
But I lack the strength to go on.
Find it, Luna Freya. You have the will. Go to Noctis. Show him the truth of your heart.
You mean Ravis wasn't a complete douche all the time? It looks like he kind of had a little bit of a change of heart.
I understand you will go hence to the Imperial capital.
Yeah.
Lord Ravis has King Regis's glaive in his safekeeping, and it was his wish to return it to you, my prince. Though I imagine it will not be easy for you to find each other.
I'll get it from him somehow.
I pray it shall be so.
Why couldn't he give it to me earlier when I saw him a long time ago? Is that because the stupid Chancellor dude was around? Stupid Chancellor dude always ruining everybody's plans. That's all we have to do here? I thought we were gonna like do like some stuff and things here, but apparently no. We just stopped here to say hello. I just stopped by to say hello. And that was all. Wow, this episode has already been pretty fast, pretty furious. I'm not gonna lie. Not only did we finish a chapter, then we did a whole nother chapter, and now we're about to go back on the train again. Is there really nothing else to do here? Can I go back to, like, Lucis right now? I'm almost tempted. Shit, I'm half tempted. What about you? What are you gonna do?
Remember how I said it was locked away?
Yeah.
They really don't allow anyone near the thing. The Emperor himself never got close to it. The lab rats had a theory that the crystal posed some kind of threat to the demons. The way they see it? That's the reason the Chancellor had the Emperor go after it in the first place. Dunno, but that theory holds water in my book.
So it was the Chancellor's idea, is what you're saying?
Certainly explains why the kings have always guarded the crystal, and how they kept the demons at bay. Long story short, we're stuck in this rut until you go and take back what's yours.
Take back the throne, my friend. Take it back. So a big reason I want to go back to Lucis is because I'm pretty darn sure that... I mean, I know we know about at least one or two weapons that we can go find, meaning the royal weapons. But there's got to be more than that that I didn't pick up back in the old area in Lucis. There's plenty of areas I never really looked inside of, so that's the main reason I want to go back and look around, because there's a big chance that I should have way more of the royal arms than what I have right now. Because the one I picked up last episode inside the cave in the mine cave, whatever we call it, the mines of Moria, where we fought the mines of Marlborough is what I should call it. Ooh, there's a weapon shop here. Let's check that shit out. Oh, you just got the same shit the last people had. Although you do have a thunderbolt, I'm not gonna lie. I kind of always wanted a second one of these. I'm gonna buy a second one. Might as well. Gotta make myself more pimpin'. But as I was saying, wait, can we climb this ladder? Can we climb this ladder? You won't. Okay, yeah, but I'm pretty sure I should have more royal arms. I mean, we know of one, right? We gotta go inside the place where the one that got stolen. Like, we have to go find that one. So that's one. But I'm trying to think if there was, like, another one that we didn't pick up. But there's also a bunch of areas we haven't really finished exploring. So I'm like, there's gotta at least be... I'm gonna go wager that there's either the rest of the ones that I'm missing, except for the one that Ravis has, or there's, like, two or three more that I didn't even, like, pinpoint. So I really just need to go back and look around.
Yeah?
Prince Noctis, were you excited to marry Lady Lunafreya?
Of course I was.
Because she was really excited to marry you. She looked so happy the day her dress arrived. She really loved you, Prince Noctis.
I... Thank you.
Okay?
At first, The father had mourned the fate of his chosen son. Yet in Tenebrae, the two found solace. It was not the Oracle who assuaged their fears. But the girl, she holds the true power.
I have little to offer a king, other than the voice afforded the Oracle. Nevertheless... And... I'm afraid you might find this foolish. But... To be together with Noctis again, even if only for a short while, it would mean the world to me. I do not seek to guide him, merely to stand beside him.
But you're the Oracle. You're supposed to guide him also.
Lady Lunafreya worried she was burdening you with the wedding. That's not true, is it?
No, not at all.
She was doing all the work anyways. Noctis was just supposed to show up. Anyway. Alright, I don't know if there's any more to that. I guess the little girl decided to... Wait, what are we reading? There's a cosmogony thing. Before falling into eternal slumber, the six bequeathed unto man one last treasure, a ring. Yet who among us was fit to possess the gift of the gods? After some time, the ring was transferred to the hands of a man blessed with powers divine, ultimately developing the mark identifying one fit to rule. So that must be the ring to rule them all. This is a straight Lord of the Rings story, man. The same ring that Noctis carries around, I imagine. What about you?
I listened to Lady Lunafreya's address on the radio.
Oh, yeah?
To think she gave that speech in the very place she was supposed to be wed. I can only imagine how she must have felt.
Okay. That was very nice of you to tell me things.
I can't believe my eyes. What do we do now?
What are we...
How could something like this happen? Is the capital okay?
Capital is not okay.
Is the manor badly damaged?
It's seen better days. So have the civilians. They've been through a lot.
And the Chancellor's the one who put them through it.
Put us through a hell of a lot, too. He never gets in our way. But he sure loves messing with us. Well, there's a good chance he got his hands on Prompto. Just hope he doesn't mess with him too bad.
Too bad. Oh, don't worry. We'll fuck him up for this.
Ravis didn't have it much better than Lady Lunafreya.
Pity we never got the chance to talk things out. Hopefully, His Majesty's glaive awaits us in the capital.
Should be, as long as Ravis has it on his person. Just hope the Chancellor isn't awaiting us too. Still can't believe House Floray has reached the end of its family line.
Hmm. I guess because Ravis can never have kids?
It's rather strange. Lady Gentiana has not graced us with her presence as of late. Perhaps she has no reason to stay, now that the blood of the Oracle is no more. Like her, others will eventually leave, and the land of Tenebrae will be lost to memory.
Meh.
I guess we should give up on
you mean we're not gonna, like, do anything here in Tenebrae? I'm assuming that mansion was, like, where Luna lived? Is that the whole point? This place, this is not cool, man. I was excited to actually explore Tenebrae. That's never gonna happen now. Talk about a tease. Oh well. Reflex enhancer indeed. Man, now I'm just sad because I thought we were going to get to explore Tenebrae. Guess not. Fucking sad. Well, what are you going to do? Anyway, I'm going to finish looking around before I call that a... Man, I don't want to call it an episode. I can't even believe we're not in an episode yet. Is time fucking moving at a crawl right now or something? Because good lord. I feel like we've done so much in this episode, and yet so little. So much action has happened, yet really, we've really not done much but watch cutscenes and talk to people. We fought a little bit of a battle, but we didn't really fight a boss or anything. It was just like cutting through some demons and some soldiers, no problem. Alright, well, before we talk to Mr. Energy. Oh, I guess I could have been playing music this whole time. That's my bad. But, oh well.
I sincerely apologize.
I just want to make sure we pick up all the shinies, because I don't think we're going to get to come back here. I would stake my wife and my life upon it. Don't have either one of those things right now, but that's cool. Alright, one of these people wanted to talk to me. You! What do you got
so
to say, kid?
You're Lady Lunafreya's fiancé, right?
Fiancé?
Want to know something?
Okay, then.
Everyone knows she liked pretty flowers, but you want to know what else she liked? Cool stickers. It has to be true.
Where are we supposed to go?
It has to be true, because if it's not, I'll kill myself. Okay, kid. Okay, calm down. Just stickers, man. It's just stickers.
Ready to depart. Just swapped out the damaged cars for some new ones. Give one of us a holler when you're ready to shove off, then.
I love their accents, by the way.
If you need a break.
Oh, now the dining car's open? Bro, why was the is this the dining car? Which one's the dining car? Did I pass up the dining car accidentally? If you need a break, the dining car's open. Is that what this car is? Wait, you? What are you?
The Empire has declared Lord Ravis a traitor and sentenced him to
death. Wait, what?
I believe the attack on the manor was further punishment.
This feels very incomplete to me. Does it not? Is it not just me, right? Like, what do they mean Ravis is a traitor? We don't even know what the hell's going on. Like, we didn't see any of that shit. Ravis was at, what's it called? He was in Altissia when the attack went down. But, like, that was it? He was there. The end. Also, which one of these is the fucking dining car? Is this one? I'm so confused. Wait, you. Let's talk to you.
Lady Lunafreya once tended a garden filled with scilla blossoms, watering the flowers herself. Sadly, the whole field went up in flames. It's heartbreaking to see what's become of it.
I mean, I guess I understand why Ravus is a traitor. I don't really need an explanation as to why he's a traitor all of a sudden. I'm just more surprised that they just kind of threw it upon us that he is a traitor. Is this the dining car? Dude, what the fuck? Oh, whatever. Let me just...
Shall we shove off, then?
I'm just gonna go. Shall we shove off, then? Yes.
Climb aboard.
Let's shove off. Where she lived, because they burned the mansion down. Bunch of assholes.
Don't worry about the civilians. They're in my good hands.
And what good hands they are, girl.
Can't say the same for you. Watch yourselves in the capital.
We will.
Thanks, Aranea. We'll see you around. It's snowing.
Get your ass on board.
Yes, sir.
Get your ass on board. Blah. Blah, see? Blah. So the further we get into this, the more I realize that maybe all the summons that we haven't gotten are the ones that are dead, because if they already basically said Shiva's dead. Anyway, a frozen ravine where fallen Shiva lies, a solitary railroad carved through its unforgiving snowscape. With Biggs and Wedge driving, the train makes its slow and steady way toward the Imperial capital. I'm still holding out hope that we can still get the other summons. I really thought we weren't going to get them. Or we were going to get them. But now I don't... There's a lot of doubt in my brain right now. I feel like there's just not enough time to get the rest of the summons. Unless they're all going to just show up here at the end. That just makes me sad, man. You can't tease me with this shit, man. But I guess for storyline purposes, it's more sad that some of the summons are dead. But still... And assuming that big face right there we're looking at is Shiva? Or was Shiva? Maybe we actually get to see her big-ass dead corpse? And make us be even more sad?
Oi! Attention all passengers! We're on our way to our final destination in the Imperial capital! Enjoy the ride!
Sit back and enjoy the ride!
Look at all that snow. No wonder it's so cold in here.
We must be approaching the Glacian's cadaver.
Won't be a blessing if all we got's a body.
Let us hope we pass through the gorge without incident.
It's what's after the gorge I'm worried about.
No, it's what's in the gorge is what I'm worried about. I need my hot Shiva girl, man. Noctis is free to roam around an empty-ass train.
Once we get through Gorobus, we're there.
We've come quite a long way.
This empty-ass train, how depressing. Okay, we're allowed to walk around the empty train. Hope you're excited about it, because it's empty as fuck. I don't even know, am I supposed to go back this way? Well, looks like there's actually a bunch of shinies in here, so... Worth it. Gimme. Stop jumping and grab the shiny, you idiot. Stop jumping like an idiot and grab the shiny. Thank you. Debased banknote. What was that? It didn't tell me. High elixir. Okay. And rusty bit. And there's lots of things. Oh, here's my car. Ooh, electrolytic condenser. All right. And a Graylian medal of distinction. And there's my car. Hey, my car. How you doing? How's my car doing, eh? And I guess we're just rolling ever closer to our destination. I don't know. Alright, so we went all the way to the back of the train where my car is stored. That's cool. I guess this is all the way in the back. I don't know. I found a bunch of blue stones. That's all I care about. Woot. Woot. Oh, wait. Whoa. There's a shiny. Glad we had time to come back the other way, because I totally ran right by that one. I'm wondering... Alright, I'm just looking out the window to see what we can see. Ooh, more blue. More bluey blues. More bluey blue, baby. More bluey blue.
It's depressing when it's always dark out.
Agreed.
Still dark. Seems there's scarcely anything left of day.
It's all gone wrong.
Indeed. All wrong. Everything is wrong. It's not very awesome. When everything's wrong, everything is all wrong, and all of us are wrong. shinies at this point. Looking for the shiniest of shinies. Not really seeing anything. Looking for the shiniest of shinies. Not really seeing anything. Hella empty ass cars everywhere. Oh shit. Oh shit. Somebody's calling me in the middle of all this?
Hey, what's up? Okay, thanks for letting us know.
Who was that? Yo, got a text from my girl. She's like, hey, Shiva up ahead. Okay. Good job on that quest, guys. We did a real good job. Good job. Proud of you guys. Proud of you guys. We did a real good job. Real good job. The Into the Crevasse. Oh, shit. Is the train actually going to freeze? I was actually kind of hoping that would be what happens. Dude, it is going to freeze. And I see her hand. Did you see her hand up there? You saw her hand. I saw her hand. We all saw her hand.
What it could be this time.
Attention now.
Yeah?
What's wrong?
You may have noticed we stopped. As for the course, outside the bridge.
We'll take a look.
Oh,
no. I hope it's just a quick snow shoveling job.
Indeed.
It might require us to move an entire Glacian. There she is. That's the big.
It's freezing.
That's her, man.
You better keep moving to stay warm.
The Glacian did this.
I think I can see her.
You think?
It's a shame. She's lying dead. Damn.
It's cold.
I like how it says, I think you can see her. Well, you know what? You might be right, seeing as how her big-ass face is right in front of you. She's gigantic, by the way. Not that we should be surprised that she's gigantic. All the fucking... Forgetting what they're called. The Hedraxion? The Hexion. All the Hexion. All of the six are giant. So I shouldn't be too surprised. Okay, did not mean to do that, but that's fine. Boom, motherfucker, get some. Get some, Wraith. You didn't wanna get some, sucker. Get rid of this bitch. Ow. Fuck up a snagga. Fuck up some snaggas. If I was a snagga by the name of Gonzaga. There you go. If I was a snagga by the name of Gonzaga. I just wanted to come up with a word that wasn't completely insensitive and offensive. Anyway, there's this giant blocks of ice all up in the way. Defeat the Deathclaw. What? I don't see a Deathclaw. Do you guys see a Deathclaw? I don't see any stinking Deathclaws. Where's the Deathclaw? Oh, that's the Deathclaw. Yeah, that looks like a Deathclaw. I tell you what, if anything looks like a Deathclaw, that's it. Shake and bake, baby. Shake and bake. Shake him before you bake him. Yeah, suck dick. Sick duck. Oh god. Okay, well I blocked hella late, but that's cool. We're good. I'm kinda whooping this thing's ass. It's just a death claw, man. Oh man, come on, I blocked. Okay, well I just fucking warp striked right when he fucking did his thing. He's fine. Shook Abe. Go team. Oh jeez. Okay. Yeah, we're over leveled for this, like super hardcore. I'm not even worried about this whatsoever. Way too overleveled for this asshole.
Sorry to break this up.
Dude! And, dude! You know what I didn't do? I forgot to equip my own double-handed piece of shit, you know? That would have probably been a good idea. Ah! Nope. This fucker's already done. Consider it already done, Deathclaw. You don't have a chance. You're just prolonging the inevitable. Which is to say, you're dead. You're dead, sucker. You're dead. Nice, got the parry. Yes! Loving that, we got the parry on him. Ooh, no, I didn't get that one though. Ignis, stop being dead. Cut it out. Being dead is not conducive to our victory. Well, honestly, we already got it with or without you. But I'd rather not let the blind guy be the one that dies, you know? Feels a little insensitive of me to let the blind guy be the dead one. Alright, anyway. Deathclaw, be gone. Nobody liked you anyways.
Ain't got time to waste.
Ain't got no time to waste. Ain't got no time, motherfucker, to waste. Waste. Get wasted. Wait, that was it? That was was it.
Hey, knocked.
That was it.
What's up?
You better get in here. Something's
got
not
it.
Right. Come on,
Iggy.
There
in a sec.
That was it.
Right.
We got off the train, we fought a Deathclaw, and then we get back on the train? Oh, fuck that.
No way.
Fuck that.
You! Hold it!
Fuck that. Motherfucking Azunia's here again? Hell no. Let's find out what he's up to next time on Final Fantasy XV. Peace.